My name is Ben, and I'll be your host and helmsman on this incredible voyage 20,000 leagues under the sea. Captain Nemo will be along momentarily. He has requested that you please refrain from all smoking, eating, and drinking. They're not allowed on the Nautilus. We'd also ask that you please refrain.
Our route will pass beneath the polar ice cap, and then probe depths seldom seen by man. So make yourselves comfortable. But please, remain seated at all times. Here among the reefs, you will see many familiar inhabitants of the undersea world. The great green sea turtles, for instance, are the reptilian patriarchs of the deep. These amphibious descendants of the dinosaur have changed little in the past 200 million years. Groupers, or giant sea bass, roam the coastal bottoms in search of food. The giant clam, obviously, is quite safe from such marine predators. The fish world has always been considered a silent habitat, but with our sonar hydrophones, we have discovered that fish actually talk. Listen. Satellite ships. They are harvesting the abundance that nature has sown here beneath the sea. Kelp beds are cultivated, sea creatures corralled and protected from predators, just as terrestrial shepherds protect their flocks from ravenous wolves. Weather alert! All controls 8 degrees down. Hold her at 80 fathoms and proceed on course. can dive safely below the violence of ocean storms. Surface vessels are not so fortunate. Witness the evidence of their fate. The graveyard of lost ships. For ages, these rotting holes have kept their secret treasures, safeguarded by silent sentinels of the deep. Man-eating sharks, nature's most unpredictable predators of the sea. Steady as she goes. In this region of the polar ice cap, you are witnessing a rare visual phenomenon, the aurora borealis above us. Take her deep and keep an eye on the depth gauge. We have passed beneath the North Pole and are now descending into that region in deeper water where the sun has never penetrated. Here, in this realm of eternal darkness, nature has provided her creatures with their own eerie luminescence. Take her back up to 80 fathoms. There are limits beyond which man and his puny efforts cannot survive. We have almost exceeded those limits. These crumbling heaps of stone betray the hand of man. I believe we've made a startling discovery. These classic ruins could very well be the legendary lost continent of Atlantis. Some scholars theorize that a remarkable civilization was destroyed by a tremendous volcano. Others treat any concept of Atlantis as pure fantasy, along with legends of sea serpents and mermaids. Belay there, mate. Anyone in his right mind knows there's no such thing as a sea serpent or mermaids. Mr. Baxter, if you think you're seeing mermaids and sea monsters, you've been submerged too long. By Neptune's flippers, this confirms it. That seething mountain still denies rest to the civilization it submerged thousands of generations ago. Helmsman, steer clear the tottering columns. Red alert!
Red alert! All hands to station.
Tanks. Steady as she goes. Good Lord. It's one of ours. Its hull has been crushed like an eggshell.
Another monster
is full repellent charge.
Repellent
charge, fire. Maximum
voltage.
All ahead.
All ahead,
fire. Emergency maneuver. All engines. Stand by to surface. Surface. Proceed on course. All ahead. Station the maneuvering watch.
Attention crew, we will be boarding momentarily. We would ask that you please remain seated until the white cabin lights above you have come on. And all the white cabin lights that are on presently, might they do come on?
Okay. Thank you. this vehicle travel quietly and in no air pollution on a system of wind reduction focus. It's kind of a fancy turret with a special electromagnet cushion for our vehicles around Tomorrowland. There are more than 600 of these electromagnets embedded along our roadway track.
For Space Mountain, so we're just cruising along at 10 miles per hour.
Thank you. I'm mommy. I'm mommy.
On our way out, okay, Cass? The waters of Snow White still pretty long, Cass. We might be able to hit that tomorrow if we have time, okay?
Can we come in real early in the
morning? No, we're going to Epcot real early.
Oh no, I can't honestly answer that.
I think it's today. I think I heard the weather.